Hello, so this is a very big update because it mostly adds the things that you want to see, meaning infinite levels, now you can be level 300, and also more items for you too, like more weapons, more armors and more trinkets, and also they did a lot of other stuff as well, but let's go over it one at a time. We have access to the ending at Chrono Station, but the very last step is still missing. Well, thank you for that. Access to obelisks, a new enemy leaper, that's actually pretty cool. He's not so bad to kill, but he will make your life miserable in the beginning. Yeah, skill cap, Tao linked our ascension level so we can have more levels. I'm not sure how hard enemies will be to kill, but they cannot be that bad. I'll have to upgrade the one in the main area, or in the first area, and see how it is. More points of interest, I mean more info on the points of interest, not so important. Our level 2, who cares about the arc, not so important. But this is the main thing you will see. New katana animation and effects. New power attack, GFX and FX. It's actually nice, but they actually limited the power attack. For example, to do the power attack, you need to be close to an enemy and you have to have him tagged. That means no more pre-power attack, so the enemy will jump into your power attack. It's kind of a bad thing. Zeni Zender, didn't see it. Craftable items. Seeker, power fist, kopesh, soldier helmets. Soldier helmet, uniform, shadow liters, okay, that's important. More info on them, tablet voice of myth, tablet voiceovers, that's also important. New quest introduced the rifts and the obelisks, well, I guess it's too late for that. And from the changes, the most important ones are weapon attack animation speeds and ranges changed. So the game will feel completely different right now, I think it's for the best, so the weapons will not feel as overpowered. Also, raise proximity mine damage to 48 from 40, double damage 48 to 96, which is great. Throwing knives are a lot better right now. Base damage was increased to 33. Sometimes rebalance lower initial crit multiplier from 2 to 1.5. That means the progress will be a lot smoother right now. It will not feel like you're going to get a lot stronger when you get a new weapon or something like that. Mana rifts show up as a question mark before completing the associated quest. Weird, but where do you get the quest? I don't know, we'll have to play and see. Sorry about the longer introduction, but I think we have a lot of things to cover, so that was kind of like what the video will contain, and now let's show everything very fast. Yes, we can craft the kopesh, and the kopesh is amazing. Actually, it's kind of like a tree cutter as well, see? As you can imagine, this has a lot of uses. Especially when... Ooh, sorry about that. Especially when you're getting wood and other materials. Poor deer. Well, I guess the deer will have to wait until we can resurrect it. I hope they give us the option to resurrect the animals. Then we have the okay, let me show you the katana. You can no longer do the power attacks before the enemy is tagged. Also, another strange item is the sickle. This item should have been given to you in the beginning. It doesn't have a lot of damage, it's only 35 slashing, but it's kind of like something between... Well, between the before the machete in the beginning, so I'm not sure how rebalanced this is, so it will probably be the sickle, the machete, and then the katana, and then finally the kopesh, or maybe the axe will be... No, katana, axe, and then the kopesh. From what I can see, this basically does what the kopesh does, only it's a little worse. I think it's not supposed to be useful at many things. The main thing it can do is destroy a lot of items at the same time in the houses. Obstacle. Okay, let's find a house with items in it. See, that's exactly what it's supposed to do, but to be honest, the kopesh just does everything better than anything else. The kopesh does more raw damage than anything else, 75 slashing. At level 1 or 0, and at plus 5 the katana does 40, with the mention that it does double damage against monsters, so that's 80 damage against monsters. So sadly, yeah, the kopesh is better in every way possible. Especially when it comes to farming, this is so much easier. Especially with the digital wishwatch, which increases the the speed of increase the speed of time by 30%. Well, I guess we should try in sleep and see what happens. Also, they changed the pictures for some things. For example, this was a water bottle, now it's the sweatband, so running speed plus 10%, so you might not find some items. The rabbit foot, digital wristwatch. Also, the lure has a new icon. Well, if I can find it, that is. Wait, where is the lure? Cannot find it in that menu. Let's go over to inventory. And it will be here, the tackle. Also, as I said about the damage of the mines. Damage versus monster. Okay, so that's versus monsters only. Material transporter plus 3. It's like a tiny box in your hand. Also, we have the master lockpick finally, but to be honest, it's going to cost me mana bits and I didn't have time to do this. I'll have to farm the rest of the items later. Lightning rod, which sounds interesting, at least in theory, but it's probably just a another trick and that you can equip, and I don't have enough space to equip anything else. Shield hit points. I'm still not sure what damage deflect means. Maybe if we get damaged, the damage will get bounced back to the enemy, I don't know. Also, the bandolier has a new icon. Rocket turrets over there, so this is everything you'd known before. Over here is the hardened military grey headgear, also known as a soldier helmet. Damage bucket in percent, damage deflect 100, and then the soldier's outfit. As you can see, it requires titanium hiding fabric. Oh, it doesn't look as cool when it's crafted. I thought it's going to be something special with stripes, with different colors, with something mystical to it, with a bit of shine because it was made with mana, but yeah, disappointed by that one. Also, now you can upgrade the sheaves trio because you don't longer need the cured leather, you just need some basic materials. Let me see. Copesh needs a lot of mana beats to be upgraded into an upgrade critical hit damage and power attack damage, so yeah, it's going to be very good at the final level if you have the patience to farm for it, because well, those mana beads are going to be in everything, so steal a number. The dice. Oh, I don't remember what this is, but now it's the dice. What that was before. Let us start the same. So yeah, that's basically the introduction for this one. Let's see if you can sleep, and then we'll try to do an obelisk. Oh, now we can sleep, huh? Also, you should put your items in the things, in the crafting stations, and then go sleep, because it will immediately finish them when you wake up. Yeah, the game is very grindy, to be honest. There's no reason to get everything, but if you want to get everything, well, it will cost you. Well, I guess this is a good way to get leaves. And you'll need a lot of leaves. Remember, the leaves are also used for agriculture, so you might want to step up your farming game. Farming for materials and also farming for vegetables and other stuff. Let's go over here, because this is the closest one. Man, that copesh really looks big and it's cutting my head. Now, does the blade he's putting on his shoulder, I don't know. They have to change some of this because he's putting the blade on his head and that should be cutting his neck. Anyway, they probably didn't thought about that. Oh, that power. Oh, that's how you kill the vultures. Oh, that's brilliant. Let's see if we can find another one, because I want to test that thing again. Maybe there are other weapons that can kill the vultures, even the rifle. Well, to be honest, I don't know how I killed it, but doesn't really matter. We have it in our monster screen right now. Let's see, collection. Creatures. They might have improved some of this as well. This is the ex-human leaper, which looks really creepy and doesn't really fit the other artwork, to be honest. I have to kill more, three more to show the description. Oh. The Law, the Reaper, the Sword. Ex-human dweller. Lose its eyes out. Yeah, it's purely using sound for navigation. They are a very weird shape and I don't know. They could have made them a little better. A vulture. I have no idea how to kill more vultures. Inspect three different obelisks. Oh. Well, that's going to be annoying. Okay, let's go at filters. Fixable. I still have four fixable things. Oh, I have so much buried treasure left. Okay, now, where are those silly obelisks? Evacuation site and Catesfield Nord. Okay. Huh, entryways. Interesting. Well, I'll have to think about the entryways later, but for now, let's go and inspect the obelisks. And then let's go to the story. Well, I guess I died, but that's for the better. Now, where is the teleporter from over here? Well, wait a minute. So, if this power attack is so strong, that means I should probably equip the soldier stuff because I don't want to die so fast. Damage block 15%. 35%. Oh, that's nice. The damage deflect, I don't know. So this is how we look for the rest of the game, probably. Yeah, where is that? Oh, yes. I remember now. It's kind of hard to navigate in this place, I guess. I came over here because it was close to everything and I have my buildings over there. Okay, let's go back. This time, let's see how much damage we take with these things. Also, we probably want to equip... No, we cannot equip the knives. Yeah. This is still... Oh, 16. You have 9. Before it was... Okay, so this is still 40. We have 22. This is 16. We have 9. Yeah, I don't know how to unlock those slots. They'll probably be in the next update. Yeah, that's definitely a bug with the vulture. I don't think we should be able to kill it with the Popeye, but hey, what do I know? Let's replace this with the rifle. The mines probably can be replaced with the knives right now since they do more damage. Okay, This is a big game changer. Doesn't look like we can kill the vultures with the normal weapon, so let's do that again. Yeah, that will take a lot of exploiting. I just need to kill one more. Sorry about this, I should have explored the obelisk before the video, but I didn't think about it. Let's see if we can kill one of the vultures. I'm curious about the description. Okay, we killed three vultures. I don't know how you're supposed to kill them, but... Yeah, good thing I picked that up. Oh, I have to kill one more. No! Okay, let's try it. Let's try it. What do we have to lose? Okay, definitely has to be a power attack. Well, that was a fast kill on the enemies. You come with me. Okay, that worked. Did that work? Okay, reimbursing. Okay, I'll have to do that camera, off camera, but it works and I've tested it. I'm actually happy about that. Okay, we're actually getting more and more closer to 100% in the game. And it's one of my favorite games, so that's why I want to bother as much with it. I ignore that death icon over there. Nothing happened. Now, the one location that I remember very clearly for the obelisk is over here. I think we have to go outside of the base. Yeah, this shouldn't be too hard. Okay. I think this is where you find your first ex-human stalker. Yeah, we still cannot break the walls, which is a major problem in my opinion, because you have to backtrack so much because of the walls, and the only reason to do that is because they probably introduce another melee weapon or, I don't know, an upgrade that will let you destroy the walls. Power up the obelisks. Yeah, we should power up the obelisks, I agree. Well, I guess you can walk all the way over there. Oh, the bony hat also has new artwork. One more for additional clues, yes. Okay, let's go there and then we'll see what we can do about ending the... Oh, that was close. I blinked. And I almost fell out the hole. And I guess we'd have met all of the tomb guards down there. Yeah, I'm not going to use that many resources. I think you need 100 mana beads for one mana chunk. Which is a lot of resources for something you probably won't use. I mean, yeah. There's no point in many of the content if you just reach this spot. I guess if you replay it when it's fully released, you'll have a different experience. But for now, I'm seeing a lot of redundant items. You know, and as the Adeptus Mechanus from Warhammer 40k says, redundancy is a sin. Oh yeah, I have to kill these guys for the mana beads. Well, I guess I'll have to come back another time. Oh, with the blue orb, blue eye orbs, okay. Oh no. Okay, let's see how many blue eyes orb we actually have. I don't. Oh no, 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 sorry about that. Okay, sorry, sorry, sorry. Why do I keep doing that? We should have the possibility to resurrect all the animals we killed. Blue elves are the only things that we didn't have a use for. I guess you get them from the bosses, if I remember correctly. Yeah, oh no, I guess you get a lot more of the blue eye orbs, but I don't remember from where. Maybe even from normal looting chest? I assume this is a battle challenge. I was not ready for that, you know. Oh. Oh, that was it? I guess it's a little buggy right now. Okay, somehow. Oh. I have to sneak around it. Okay, level 2. Same, another reward. Okay, this is getting scary and I'm running out of HP. I guess you could put mine all over the place, but I don't have the mines with me. More? More than this? Okay, okay. This is getting dangerous right now. Yeah, they definitely need to fine-tune this one because I was getting hit before I could move. When you activate the obelisk, you can move for a few seconds, apparently. I hope that was the last one. Okay, so when you finish the obelisk, you actually get a point, you actually get a unique ability or unique passive that will help you a lot. 5000 experience. Evade chance plus 9%, so... Oh, it says evade chance plus 1%. Also, oh, we have audio logs over there. Oh, that's nice. One thing we didn't really do is use the underway passages. And that's actually one of the areas that were not... For example, this area was never used because I don't know how to get there. Probably with the rift or something like that. Shelter, I have a time crane over there. Yeah, we still have the underway passages to be used. Okay, let's see them. Or the entryway. Yeah, this and... Oh, well, I guess... The entryways are supposed to show you where you can enter underground. Okay, that's a lot of fun, but we still have to go to the final area of the game. Is there a tower nearby? Okay, yes, there is Junction Station. It's a little bit buggy. I guess the obelisks will get fixed, but for now they're a little bit buggy. Sadly, they don't have a big effect on the screen like I would have hoped. For example, this should have been a bigger white outline. Kind of like the obelisk shining into the sky. Probably I chose the worst obelisk because that dodge chance seems a little bit underpowered. Okay, let's see what the crown has to offer us. I guess we cannot damage the enemy if they are on another level. Can you damage them through the furniture? Oh yes, you can damage them through furniture. No, probably not. I think I'm supposed to go this way to the crown entrance. Okay, let's rest a little bit over here by the fire. Oh, that's a lot of experience I just got. Actually, you know what? As long as we're here, we can listen to the king study. Let's see how the voice acting changed. Well, that is if I can remember where to go. No. Yeah, the outside gym, that looks impressive. Let's see the voice acting for this.
We should not trust any of the king's descendants, said the elders. All women and children descendants were banished off the island into them. So the king were buried alive in a...
Okay, that's actually pretty good. It's pretty good voice acting. Now, do I remember where I have to go? Probably over there. The last audio log? Oh man, this map is so confusing right now. Okay, let's center it on the north. And let's see how we get there. Collapse Launchpad Road. Oh, this is the cutscene I was supposed to get when I entered the fortress with the radio signal, but yeah. I guess better late than never. I guess if you use this weapon, you'll break everything. I didn't touch everything. Or maybe it was added after. Oh, that scared me. What? I thought there were not too... Man, I was not even looking turrets. Why? Well, I guess this is not a game if it doesn't have the turrets. No, I'm not sure that's the right way. Also, it's a bit late in the day and I want to finish this as fast as possible, but the game keeps delaying me. I had my computer crash when I was recording this. Just annoying to say the least. Yeah, it's going to be very hard for people who play this to remember all of the stuff I'm doing right now. If they're playing the game for the first time and they reach this point, it might not be so clear. But I guess the game will get more optimization and more stuff. More balance change. Oh, it didn't want to target the turret, but now it is targeted. I hope I can shoot it. Okay, that worked. Okay, for a moment I thought I wouldn't have to do a lot of other nonsense, but no. Oh, probably this is the final campfire in the... well, the final campfire you reach in the game. They're fighting. Oh, just some deer. I guess the deer are the natural enemies of the zombies. No, don't go down there. I want to go the other way. Almost, but not quite. this feels like... managed to precious to leave behind. No, live with your life. This reminds me of the Prey sequence when you actually get to the shuttle. I am pretty sure that will not be the end.
Personal audio log. About mana is extremely valuable. We must not lose this knowledge. I can't wait to share this with the rest of the world.
Oh, you wanted to share
but
it.
We need to overcome the pestilence first. How can I fix this? Or can I even fix this? Are we doomed each time?
Each time?
I've got to keep trying. This is so frustrating. It makes me want to break things.
...10,000 experience. Each time, That sounds probably more interesting than it should. I guess there are no more secrets in the game right now. We can safely climb down here. Looks like I killed a deer on accident. By the way, that's the human leaper. No, it doesn't seem to do much right now. It actually leaped at me. Okay, that scared me. Huh. Very interesting guy. Also, let's catch some fishes because we might find the one that we need. The new one, that is. equip the fishing pole. You cannot shoot at the fish. Ah, what a relaxing period. Yeah, fishing is also one of the best way to get experience. I mean, look at this. 2500 experience, 3000 experience. 4000. 4000 experience, well, that's not too bad, I would say. Zenizender, the new type of fish. Okay, we have mostly gotten and seen all of the new content. I don't have an egg with me. Oh, you can actually go to this area, interesting. Like this, there's nothing over here. Okay, so that concludes the exploration phase of the update. Let's go back and let's see what we can do. Also, no new recipes, at least not so far. Yeah, this was an interesting little detour. I knew it, I knew it. Okay, let's just bend the chap and go over there where we are busy. Hey, you haven't died in a while. Do you want to die? No, no, I don't want to die. Guess what? You meet the explosive thrower guy that will make you die. I don't know, it seems that enemy kills me the most because it's the one that can almost one-shot you. Let's see how much experience that will be. I guess this doesn't lead anywhere, or we cannot enter it. I guess it will lead to the launch. I don't get the structure of this place, but I guess I shouldn't really understand it either way. Yeah, so you're not even supposed to go down there, even though the enemies would suggest to go down there to check it out. Hey, check out the monsters. There will be loot. No, there won't be loot. Okay, so let's go into the final area of the game. So this kind of implies that you can restart your game probably by keeping all of your materials and tools. Warm up the engine, complete all collections in there. That's the only two quests I have left. Arc lab key? Really? Well, now I have to go to dark. Spot one engine. Okay, how do you fight them then? Oh, it's one of those defense missions and I didn't put down any turrets. Oh, I cannot move. Wait, is this one bugged or is it not in the game currently? Probably is not in the game. Let's try that again. I mean, there's not much to think about. It's a straight line to the ship. Okay, we'll probably try this the next time. Now, I'm really curious about that arc. Let's go into the arc. I want to see if you can actually open something else with the arc lab. Yeah, I think that's what it said, the arc. Okay, we have to look in our keys. Collection. Keys. Okay, sure, we can go in the final. Oh, they're really trying to get that gear. I guess we're fighting on equal terms right now. With the... Well, with the zombies that throw stuff at you that explodes. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a longer road back. Well, that was a very lucky hit. And I don't know, the new mechanics are nice, but it's very hard to control the sword and your swing. Oh. Why did I spawn over here? Because I used the chest, okay. It's like it's very hard to control your swing direction. I didn't have this problem before. Yeah, they might need to look at some of the changes. Should not be there. Go away. Yeah, they might need to also add a teleporter near to this place because... I mean, people might want to leave to do something else. I still have to farm most of the shelters because I didn't finish them. And then I'll actually try the base... Why are you so accurate? Dark Lab actually Dark Lab key implies that there is something in dark, so you might need to finish the whole arc before you can access that area, but let's check it out right now. Because if it is what I think it is and you need to finish the arc projects to enter Dark Lab and you have the key, well, I guess we'll have to do those things as well. Even though it's the grandest part of the game. I wish they'd introduce more locations like this one, but I guess we cannot be picky about it. Okay, I guess this is... For a moment I thought I would not find that. You know what, let's just kind of save over here, because if I die I want to respawn over here. Remember, you're basically using an elevator to go underground and see the bunker. Ah. No, I don't think we can open anything.
10 samples deposited. 30 samples deposited. This collection is now 11% complete. 10 samples deposited.
Yeah, this will take a long while.
This collection is now 12% complete. By harvesting the land, we were able to thrive.
No, I think this does nothing. The lab key doesn't do anything unless you complete all of the Ark collections. You know what I have to do for this one? Yeah, you guessed it.
40 samples deposited. 60 samples deposited. 100 samples deposited.
1700 leaves. That's what I have to collect. Yeah, I guess you have to complete all of the collections and then you'll see if you'll get something or not. Look at this. Oh, I see turrets over there. Ah, interesting. So there might be something after this. There might be something in this room particularly or after this room. So I guess we have one more room over here and then another one. And something in the middle, probably the lab way. See, well, I guess that's it for now. See you next time. Bye.